Hello and welcome to Vaughan Dean College Theatre and Performance. So what we've done is we've made this presentation for you to look through. There are slides, videos, some information just to introduce ourselves to you, and you can get a chance to see some of the spaces that we work in, the type of work that we do, and the type of work that our students get to do while they're here with us. The slides presentation should last about 20 to 25 minutes. You can pause it and work through it at your own leisure. So welcome once again to Vaughan Dean College Theatre and Performance, and I hope you enjoyed the presentation.
Hello, I'm Jill and I'm Programme Leader for Theatre, and I teach on the A level and the BTEC Performing Arts and Theatre courses, and also on the IB World Lit.
I'm Steve and I'm Programme Leader for BTEC Vocational courses in Performing Arts at Vaughan Dean College. I teach on the Diploma, the Extended Certificate and the Level 2 Performing Arts courses.
Hello, I'm Sian. I teach on the Performing Arts BTEC and the Theatre A-Level.
Hi, I'm Nikki and I teach on all of our Drama and Theatre Performing Arts courses at Vaughan Dean College.
We offer a range of courses at Vaughan Dean College. First, we offer a BTEC Performing Arts Vocational Qualification. So we offer a single extended certificate. Now that's the equivalent to one A-level, but we also offer a diploma, which is the equivalent to two A-levels. So that's two different courses. Both courses are highly practical. You will explore a range of texts, some devised work, whole range of different genres. You'll look at different practitioners. Everything is based around and built around individual projects that give you an opportunity to explore and develop skills for yourself for acting. Each of those projects will culminate in a live performance. If you're doing the diploma, it gives you a broader opportunity to explore a range of different performance opportunities, which include performing at the Warren Theatre as part of the Brighton Fringe Festival, as well as other opportunities to perform in outside locations or in non-traditional theatre spaces. We also offer the A-level Drama and Theatre Studies course. Now that's 60% practical and 40% written work. Through that A-level, you'll get to explore lots of aspects of theatre and drama. You'll be looking at texts, you'll be looking at direction, design, and pulling all of those different principles together to explore a range of texts and create work in a very collaborative way. Each of our courses are explored very practically. You get to do lots of game playing and exercises and warm-ups in lessons, and then you apply what you've done to. What we're going to do is have a look at some of the different work that we do on these various courses and explore some of the spaces that the students get to work in while they're here at Vaughan Dean College. On the next slide.
Like so many people, we have been thinking of the way the Black Lives Matter movement has shaken the world. The next video shows student-devised work which explores the way that casual and commonplace racism can be hidden in plain sight. It's called I'm Not a Racist, But.
With the hope of generating discussion about the way history seems to be constantly repeating itself. It seems to us that whilst British values are being promoted in schools, true values of welcome and acceptance are being overlooked. Today we are going to show you three different scenes, each from a different point in the last century. And perhaps you can begin to think about what it means to be racist.
Thank you. late to refuse the refugee child now. You've already told the neighbours. I only wish you hadn't consented to it in the first place.
Well, if not me, then who?
Perhaps you should like me to send a telegram, ask the National Socialists to take her back.
We can't afford this madness. They have set up camps for the ones with no sponsors. The Jewish children have different traditions. They won't mix well.
Camps? She's only here because her parents are in a labour camp and the brown shirts destroyed her home.
Is she here?
Oh, I'm going now.
Look, Granny, I've been practising my German. Ich heiße Liza.
German? Surely the child will speak English.
Of course she will. She'll be ever so grateful we took her in. She'll be so happy that we invited her.
And what if she's not? What if she's rude and mean? Should you still like to take her in then?
She wouldn't be.
Shall I take your case? Nein, lass mich allein.
Can I get you something to eat?
Ich habe Hunger. Haben Sie Essen zu Hause?
I'd like you to try and speak English if possible.
Ich verstehe nicht. Warum sprechen Sie immer auf Englisch? Ich will Deutsch. Ich will nach Deutschland.
Ungrateful. Rude. Mean.
Frightened. Alone. Helpless.
Did you have to bring a Yid into our home?
Kristallnacht.
9th of November, 1938.
Their orphanage was burnt down by the Nazis.
2nd of December, 1938.
Train, then boat.
200 children arrived at the station from Harwich.
From the orphanage in Berlin.
You didn't have to pick one.
Awful,
you didn't have to pick this
understand.
One. They we take our child, to be welcome, but they don't read the language. They hate Britain.
In my own home,
and
I
they hate
an anti-Semite.
In einer kleinen Liebelei im Herzen ist alles Lebensspielerei. Man darf so wissen, so darf so wissen, so darf so wissen, so darf so wissen, so darf so ein bisschen mit Musik doch da.
This is a poem by Bertolt Brecht about not forgetting the sacrifices that were made for us.
The plays we teach often contain difficult ideas and actions as a way of exploring and challenging assumptions about the world we live in. It's something to keep in mind when you're choosing your courses.
So what makes drama and performing arts different from studying other subjects? Well, I think key and fundamental to studying drama and performing arts is the way that the students work together as groups. They work in a very practical way. They're often working in a very playful and explorative way. There's lots of trust involved. So how to build that trust, how to build that foundation to allow students to be able to express themselves and really challenge themselves to try things out that are quite adventurous. So what's really important is students coming in ready to work and willing to take part in warm-up exercises that get them to warm up physically, and get them to explore a range of skills and to work together as a team. So we're going to have a little look at drama students working in the drama studio, which is our main teaching and learning space. So these videos, you can't hear the sound on, but you can see students working in the space. The drama space here is set up, it's just a very working space, it's not set up like very presented for a performance, but you can see the students working, moving around the space, doing something like the video just to my right. So you can see the students are just doing something very simple like bouncing a ball, but in doing so they're working collaboratively. It's teamwork, it's focus, it's concentration. Students can assess what level they're at and can work to improve it. This is really important to students to reflect on their achievement and to come back and work on developing skills. In the video above, you can see teams working really closely, very physically, moving around the space and having to solve problems together to work as a team. And that's really important. So as well as just working in these group activities, the students here are having to solve problems, but also in working through this work, they're already working on character. So some of the work that they're doing in that exercise will then be used as part of character work for exploring in text. So we're going to have a look at some of the other work that students do in the studio and in other spaces that we use at college in the next few slides.
Hello, I'm Sian. I'm another drama teacher at Vandine College, and I'm going to take you through the next few slides. So this is a photo of some of our theatre studies students devising some work, which means creating their own pieces. The drama studio is a very flexible, adaptable space to suit all styles of theatre. We use it for rehearsals, performances, and we've got a really lovely set of lights and sound. We like to create a really safe environment for all our classes, so you feel able to take risks and challenge yourselves. This is some of our diploma students working on a play, Lungs, which is a beautiful play that was recently performed at the Old Vic Theatre. It requires the students to really focus on Stanislavskian techniques to really gauge the character, thinking about objective, magic if, and really creating that feeling of naturalism, realism. And as you can see, this is the drama space transformed into a traverse theatre. The Drama Hut is another space we use for rehearsals. Often students go and use it lunch breaks to develop their pieces. Again, it's a lovely space where you can work. Always a good idea to read a script. Even if you're doing just a small part of a script, it's really, really good idea to read the entire script. It just shows and marks the character's journey and relationships with other characters. Also, it's interesting. This is an example of some students reflecting on their own devised work. It's really, really important that you analyse and evaluate your work and others. It's a really important part of our process, and you learn a lot from it. You can make your performances better and you can help others. This is an example of the beginning of working with physical theatre.
Students enjoy and learn from working alongside industry professionals, so we invite practitioners in to run workshops with the students. The first image is at Hiccup, a physical theatre company who've worked with devising skills and general physical confidence. The next company are Out of Joint Theatre, and they came in to run a specific acting workshop with the students. You see, some of them have got cards on their heads, so I think they were doing status at this point in time. Inroad Productions have come along to do a storytelling workshop. The students are creating their own original stories for using in pieces of theatre. And this is a puppetry workshop run by Bauer Bird Productions from Prague, They were here for the Brighton Festival with a puppet production of Richard III. You can see these beautiful puppets the students were able to work with and animate. And also we were able to go outside that day and work on the field above the drama studio because the weather was so lovely.
So that's just an example of some of our students working in the drama studio for their performance. We were talking a little earlier about working in ensemble, and that's a really good example of showing the work the students can do working together as a team. Lots of synchronized movement, choreography, and also thinking about the way that they used their costumes, which were all very similar costumes, but just accented with different colours. The way that they used their props, the way that those props also got to use sound. And then from this group activity, this choral movement, characters emerge, principles emerge. I'm going to have another look at another video, which also shows students working in a very physical way, working as a team together, as a company, as an ensemble.
At Vanding College, we
always look for other external venues for us to show our student work. And here are performers from a few years ago warming up for their presentation of the play Road by Jim Cartwright. And this was at the Circle Arts Centre in Portslade. Here, students on the BTEC sub-diploma and diploma courses rehearsed for their production, A Midsummer Night's Dream. As you can see, the actors are working with a thrust stage. So we're always looking for ways to present the student work. Every year, we perform at the Warren Theatre as part of Brighton Fringe, and this is students just having some notes from one of the teachers before they went on to perform. Here was our production of Threepenny Opera down in the basement in the North Lane in Brighton. And the Old Market in Hove is a venue where we've taken student work over a number of years. And this was a production of As You Like It. We have a great relationship with Brighton Open Air Theatre, BOAT. And last summer, we took students for a workshop and they presented scenes from As You Like It and Tartuffe to each other. This was A-level students, you can see here, as well as BTEC performing arts students.
Something that the performing arts industry and drama and theatre really excels in is its links with community and the way that it works in collaboration with communities and other companies. At Vinding College, if you're involved in the drama and theatre or performing arts department, you'll find yourself working in collaboration with other people. Here you can see workshops being run by performing arts students for a group of international students that have come and joined in their summer term. So there are students from China and from Italy, and they were invited to a workshop that was run by our performing arts students with a whole sequence of games and exercises that maybe those students weren't used to playing games in the classroom in that same way, and you can see them really enjoying themselves here. Those same students also performed for the international students as part of a performance for a festival that we did of outdoor theatre in the college that summer. Earlier you saw a clip of students working in a workshop, and this culminated in a production with Brighton University called Making a Drama Out of a Crisis. Here are some slides of the work that took place on the stage there. In addition, in the year, our students are often asked to work with media students who get to make a short film. They're looking for actors, so they often ask for performers from our department, and people can take part in their short film production. This really gives the students an opportunity to find characters, develop characters, work with a text, and get experience of working on camera and within the process of filmmaking, working to shot, going back and re-recording shots.
There are plenty of opportunities while studying drama and performing arts at Vinding College to go and see live performance. We regularly visit local theatres, as well as attending shows in London, and this picture was taken last year when we took A-level students to see As You Like It at the Globe. This picture was taken at Chichester Festival Theatre. And here was an opportunity at Chichester Festival Theatre where students were invited onto the set of Much Ado About Nothing for a post-show Q&A with members of the Royal Shakespeare Company. We're also lucky enough to get some tickets occasionally to go and visit Glyndebourne Opera House, which is just up the road.
Here at Vanding College, we believe that drama is joyous, creative, experimental, and good for your spirit. Thank you for joining us here today. We hope you've enjoyed our presentation, and we really look forward to meeting you in person